In this session, we are going to talk about subforms and specifically about static subforms, which this is a new feature that Zoho just released. If you see my screen, you can see that I have here, in this opportunity, I have a subform. A subform, for the people that don't know, will be a collection of details that can be in a way like Excel. So instead of having like the fields on the top, you will have key value, which means for each one of the fields, I can have only one value. You can have here multiple values in each row. So here, for example, this is a collection of products. Which products are part of this specific deal, which is a very common subform that we are having with our clients. I can click on adding a new one. I will select, and I will have, for example, wall graphics will be 50 of those. We'll click on yes. And then we'll have also frosted film will do 20 of those. Okay, so those will be the products that I selected, and that will be how you're using a subform. I also have on the channel lots of videos of how to create a subform like that, but for now we are concentrating on the static subform. Before we begin with the static subform, I want to explain what it means. There are sometimes businesses that will need to collect information that is more in a structured way. As an example, if I am a wealth manager and I am onboarding a new customer, I will need to collect from them their social insurance number, their passport, and driving license. Maybe those are supposed to be pictures. And also I need the valid date until when it's valid. And maybe who issued this document, it's a government or state and so on. In that case, it's not one field for the passport. It will be multiple values for one passport, which means I need it to be in a row kind of entry. And I also don't want to think about it. I want it to be static and waiting for me. And that's exactly what we're going to do right now. So let's assume that I'm going right now to the modules and fields, and you can do it from the setup screen or from where I just did it. It's all the same. And I'm going to have a subform that I'm going to pull. Let's call this passport, this subform. We'll call it a qualification process. And instead of setting a standard subform, I will select static. Now, if you don't have this feature yet, and we are your Zoho partner, drop us a line. We'll help you with adding this feature. Obviously, we're not charging for those kind of requests. So we will be happy to help you. I'm selecting static, and then I'm saving and adding the field. So let's assume that as part of my process, I need to have passport. I need to have also a driving license. So those will be the two items that I will need always to collect. For each one of them, let's call it doc type. For each one of those, I will need to have more information. If you're going with the add field, that will be any kind of a field. It will be a single line, email field, URL, pick list, and so on. If you're going with a static field, it will do exactly what we did here. Those will be static fields, one below the other. So in my case, I need to have who issued this document. And I also need to have a date field that will tell me valid until date. Okay, you can also have more fields with the picture and so on, but I'm trying to make this session really simple. Let's click on save. And let's go back to one of my leads. If I have one, beautiful. I have a lead named Test. Go figure it out. It's crazy. Okay. So let's go to my subform, and this is the qualification process. Let's click on edit. And now when I'm clicking on edit, you can see that I have here the doc type, it's passport and driving license. Both of them are static, which means I cannot change them. And even if you want, you can make it mandatory, which means whenever you're doing the qualification process, you must enter this information. Issued by will be, let's say, USA, and this one will be New York, and this is valid until this date, and this is valid until this date. And whenever, first of all, you can see that when I'm entering the information, it's all structured, so I don't need to think too much. It's awesome. Also, it's relatively fast. Ignore this message. This is a testing environment. When you click on save, now you can see that the information is here. Okay? So what you're gaining from it is to have some kind of a structure and predefined subform that will help you collect information. I would say that this type of a document will be fantastic for qualification process, fantastic to collect information whenever a client is already onboarded. The more structure that you will introduce to your system, the faster your team will work and the easier it will be for to onboard new employees to the system. The more people need to think, so okay, I just onboarded someone. I need to collect, wait a second, a passport and driving license. And then I need to ask for where it was issued and valid until. Too much. That's just two fields. If you do it with some kind of a process behind it, like a kiosk or a blueprint and a static subform, you introduce more and more structure, much easier to operate, less mistakes, more revenue. Thank you very much for watching this session. If you have any questions, thumbs up is always appreciated. Thank you for your time. We'll see you in the next video.